Is why you ask us for our IDs, please?
Ma'am, the reason I asked you for your ID is because I came in here and I saw that you guys are speaking Spanish, which is very unheard of up here.
Okay.
Just run your name, date of birth.
We have absence. You say
the Jews because our profile, right?
No.
Racial profile. Purple.
It has nothing to do with that.
No.
It's the fact that it has to do with you guys speaking Spanish in the store.
Spanish in the store.
In the state where it's predominantly English speaking.
Okay.
Joining me now via Skype, the woman you heard in that video, Anna Suda. Anna, thank you so much. I mean, we just heard in that video that you shot. So walk us through what happened at this gas station.
Well, we need some, like in the video, you can see we need some eggs and my friend needs some milk for her daughter. So we decide to go to the gas station because we don't have stores open. That was the only store, so we stopped there. Well, we pick up the items, and I was in line. I was going to pay. I was next in line, and I hear my friend say something. So I look back, and was this Border Patrol agent. He looked at me, and he asked me where I was born. So I look at him, and I say, "Are you serious?" He's like, "I'm very serious." Hmm. I say I was born in El Paso, Texas, and he looked at my friend, and my friend say I was born in El Centro, California. So he said, "I need to see your ID." I say, I need your ID. So I say, "I'm going to pay, and then I will give you my ID." He say, "No, you are going to give me your ID." So I say, "Okay, I will give you my ID, and then I'm going to my truck, and I'm going to pick up my cellular phone, and then I'm going to record you." He say, "Okay." So I give him my ID. He went outside, and I pay for my items, and I pick up my cellular phone, and I start recording.
How long were you out there in the parking lot? How long did he question you?
Well, I believe it was like 35 to 40 minutes for the whole thing.
It was that long?
Yeah.
So
yeah, like 40 minutes.
When he said that I want to see your ID because you're speaking Spanish, I mean, that is, most people would consider, I mean, that is racial profiling. Does he not understand that?
Well, to me it is. You know, I am not a lawyer, but to me it is.
What if you were speaking German or French or some other language?
You need to ask them because I don't know what happened. You know, I asked at the last, when they give me my paperwork, a supervisor came and he said, "Is everything okay?" I say, "No." Say he just asked me for my ID because I was speaking Spanish, like you see in the video. Is that the reason he gave me? And he say, "Oh, okay." I say, "No, it's not okay. It's if a Canadian, because we are in a Canadian border, cross the border and start speaking French, are you going to ask him for an ID like you ask me?" And then he said, "They don't do that."
Hmm.
So try to tell me that Canadians don't speak French when they come to United States.
Anna, here's what the U.S. Customs and Border Patrol told CNN. It says that they're reviewing the incident, adding that they have the authority to question individuals, make arrests, and take and consider evidence. What do you say to that?
Well, I wasn't doing any criminal. I believe they need to have a reason to stop you, not just because you speak Spanish. I don't believe that is a reason. I don't believe that's a crime.
Your 7-year-old daughter saw the video and said, "Should you not speak Spanish anymore?" How do you explain this to her?
Well, I was upstairs and she watched a video with my husband. I didn't watch it at that time. And she came and say, "Mommy, it's like you were on the television." I say, "Oh, I know." She's like, "We can't speak Spanish anymore." Hmm. So I feel very sad. Is when I decide I'm going to, you know, to bring this to somebody else for help, the ACLU, because I told her, "You need to be proud, Bondra. you need to be proud because you speak Spanish and you speak in English. You are very smart. You speak two languages.
Right.
And you need to be proud to speak Spanish. You need. How can you explain to a 7-year-old this?
Yeah. Well, Anna, thank you for coming on. Will you please keep us updated as to what happened?
Of course.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
And when we come back, I want to talk more about this story. Is what's happening in Washington, some of the policies being proposed, is that emboldening this kind of behavior?